Hello, in this video I will show you how you can explore the different datasets that DisGeNET offers. And we will start with an example. It's a disease, Duchenne muscular dystrophy. That is a condition that affects boys and is a severe genetic condition and for which there is currently a lot of research going on to develop new treatments. So we can start searching in the search box. So when you start typing, you can see that there are different types of or similar diseases to muscular dystrophy of Duchenne, but we will go through this later. Now we will select one of them, the muscular dystrophy, and we click to submit the search. You can see that there is different data sets that are available for this disease. The first one in this tab, the GDA, pertains to the gene disease associations, but we can also explore the variant disease associations or VDAs and the disease-disease associations. One thing it's nice to see is that for each search that we conduct, in this case a disease, we can explore or learn more about the disease by clicking in this eye icon, where we can see the different classification of the disease, the different ontologies and terminologies that are assigned to this term, and also different synonyms that can be used to refer to the disease. So let's go and explore a little bit the table where all the data is shown. In this case, we have the list of genes that are associated with the condition, and you see at the bottom the total number of genes. And if we slide at the right, we can see other columns that are available in this table. You can customize the view of the table by selecting the different available columns. For instance, we can remove some of them and add, for instance, pathways or protein class annotations. Another interesting feature is that you can move the columns to other positions that you prefer, or even you can lock the columns at the start or the end of the table. So in this way you can customize the view for your own purposes. Okay, so then you can explore more in detail the variants that are associated with the disease. So you can go to the VDA tab and it will display all the genomic variants associated with the condition. And different columns are shown in the table that are relevant for genomic variants, like the consequence type and also the chromosomal location of the variant. In this case is the chromosome X, because our variants of the DMD gene, the dystrophin gene. I would go back and show you another way by which you can explore the variants. You can use the variants located in particular genes, and by clicking in this column you will be redirected to the variants of the dystrophin gene that are associated to Duchenne, but also to other conditions. And the third data set that you can explore is the disease-disease association. And this is interesting if you are studying disease comorbidities, or you are willing to learn more about the different traits and manifestations of a particular disease. So if you're interested in exploring what are the diseases related to Duchenne, you can use, for instance, semantic similarity, and for that you can choose to rank those diseases using the so-called index. And also you can explore semantic relations, in this case semantic associations between different manifestations of the disease and the disease itself. I'll show you now how you can explore other view of the data that are graphs. But for that we will go back to the search box and add other types or varieties of Duchenne. So we saw at the beginning that we have the muscular dystrophy of Duchenne, but also we have a variety that is Duchenne and muscular dystrophy, so we can pick this, or cardiomyopathy in Duchenne that is also interesting to explore, and many others. Or we can even type other search queries to add potentially related disorders. And we click on search. And we will see the results in the table as before. And here you can see the different search terms that we have chosen. But we can also visualize the results as graphs. So DisGeNET offers two types of graphs on the web. One is a heat map, where you can visualize how the different diseases we selected for the search are related, or if they share patterns of common genes. Like in this case, we see that some of the diseases are sharing annotations to the same genes, but others have their own unique profile of genes associated. So the heat map here is showing the values of the score, but it can also be changed to show the number of publications or other metrics that we have in the database, like the evidence index. And these graphs can be downloaded as image files or data files. Another visualization option are networks, where you can explore the associations between the diseases and their genes using a graph format, and you can customize the network using different layouts for your own purpose. Well, with that, I show you several tips to customize your views, and you are ready to conduct your own searches.